Hey, this is Ray Dombrowski from the Vector Lab. Today I'm going to show you our bonus set that comes along when you order t-shirt templates number 01. Basically what I did was, I was starting to get a lot of emails from people that are a little bit more novice users of Photoshop and Illustrator, and they're having a little bit of trouble with all the layers and masks and that sort of thing that are in the advanced templates. So what I wanted to do was make this a lot easier for pretty much everybody to use. If you know Photoshop, you know Illustrator, and you know how to use layers, these should be pretty straightforward. So basically what I'm going to go through is a little tutorial and show you how to use both of these collections. So first I'll show you the Photoshop templates. The way these work is you've got a top shading layer that's transparent, and basically what that does is it gives a t-shirt dimension. Your art will be pasted into the middle layer here, and then on the bottom you've got your color layer, which you can change and make basically any color. Right above that you have a heather layer that you can turn on or off. So let's just get right into it. I've got a tiger stripe pattern. I'm going to copy and then paste right into here. And, this would be like for a kid's shirt, that sort of thing. I don't know who would really want to wear it otherwise. First of all, you want to crop out the artwork if it goes to the edge. To make it look like it's actually on the t-shirt. And the way to do that, there's actually a number of ways to do it. We've got clipping paths in here if you know how to use those. I actually prefer to use layer masks. That's just the way I like to do it, and I'll show you that really quick. You can hit just Command-click your path, and then go layer mask, reveal selection. So that just crops out the edges. The reason I like that is all the art is still there, and you can move it around inside of that layer mask. Sorry, I had the wrong thing clicked. You click on the art, unlink it from the t-shirt, and see how you can kind of move it around to position it how you want it. And the next thing I'll show you is how to change the color of the t-shirt. Just select all, Command-A, and then go Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation, and you just slide the bars around till you get something you like. And we'll go full crazy tiger here. Tony the Tiger. And the other thing you can do, which I like to do a lot, is to add a little bit of transparency to your art. That way, it just kind of tends to blend in with the shirt a little bit and looks a little bit more real. So we can just turn down the opacity a little bit, and you can see how that makes it follow the form of the shirt. Another thing we can do is, just for fun, I'll invert that tiger stripe art. It was black. Just go Image, Adjust, Invert. Change it to white, and then you can really see how the form of the t-shirt goes on the art and makes it look real. So there you go. There's a little Halloween costume t-shirt for your kid. And that's all you have to do. And I think I mentioned this before. I don't remember. You can add in multiple layers. Like, let's say you wanted to put in a logo on the chest, that sort of thing. You can just paste in multiple layers. So that was Photoshop. Let's go to the Illustrator templates now. I've got one of these open. It looks very similar to the Photoshop templates. Layer setup is also very similar. Top layer is T-shading. That's the transparent layer that gives it dimension. Right under that's your art. The bottom layer is a tea color, and then right above that is your heather overlay option. So here we go. I'll just take our logo, copy, and then you can just paste it right into there. Place it how you want to see it. And just to change the color, you can select that that object in the bottom layer there. And let's just go gray. Easy. And to turn on our heather look, you just turn on the opacity of it. All of a sudden you have a heather t-shirt. And I'll show you one more thing, how to crop out your logo. If let's say you want to do like a oversized print, that sort of thing. So I'm going to go back in. I didn't have this grouped. I'll go ahead and group it to make it a little easier. And just for kicks, we'll have it kind of overlay right there. Basically, all you need to do, select that bottom shape again, that color shape, copy, and then go back to your logo, and then paste in front, that's Command F, and select your logo, Command 7, crops it out. So that's how you do that. You know, if you wanted to do the tiger stripe thing on this, you could. And these are just really versatile. Again, they're just really simplified compared to the original versions. So you get the original, you know, very advanced templates. They have the little neck labels. They have some little extra bells and whistles. But really, I mean, you know, for graphic design that I do, this is kind of how I like to keep it. I mean, they have, you know, still a realistic look to them. And they're just really easy to use, real lightweight. And just check on TheVectorLab.com. You should be able to find it. T-shirt templates number 01. Thanks a lot.